coming to you from the Lake Placid Olympic Jumping Complex, the venue of the 1932 and 1980 Olympic Games. Totally refurbed though and modernized only last year. It's about 2 miles from Lake Placid itself, and that's where many of these people have come. They've traveled the short distance to come and support not just their athletes, but all the athletes competing from around the world. And tonight's session is the men's normal hill individual. Each athlete will jump twice and their two scores added together. And the highest scorer at the end wins the gold. Conditions really good tonight. Not as cold as it has been, -4. More importantly, the wind, well, it's very, very light, which is, of course, what we're looking for ski jumping. This is our start list, 22 men from 7 countries. Japan represented by 4 men. Kazakhstan and Austria also have 4. The biggest contingent are the Poles with 5, 2 Americans, 2 Norwegians, and an athlete from the Czech Republic there in 13th place. This is the order in which they will jump, but then the final round, the order will be decided by their points. So whoever has the most points will go last. Whoever has the least points after the first round will go first in the second round. Nikita Devyatkin of Kazakhstan. See the wind points there. Obviously, if the wind gets up in various directions, it's going to affect the jump, especially through the air. And so the judges take that into consideration. And there is a technical director who checks that. And his sole kind of job here is to work out the compensation points. It's all done mathematically. You can see just a couple of meters from the all-important red line.
All right, that was a beautiful
112.6.
That puts him into the first place so far out of our 3 athletes.
Next Japanese athlete, Ryusei Ikeda. Studies at Keio University. 22-year-old, looking to emulate some of the huge successes Japan has had in this sport. Oh, that's a nice one. That's long. That's a good distance of 88 meters. So that matches Devyatkin's. But what about the points from the judges now? It's good style, legs straight. It's all about controlling your balance. And the points are looking pretty good from the judges. 114.7 in total, and that puts him top of the pile for the moment. Kachenko of Kazakhstan. 22 years old, bronze at the Junior Worlds a couple of years ago. So he's been there and done it. That was a good launch. And a good length as well. And that could be our longest jump of the night so far. Oh, 86 meters. But 86 meters for him, it's still a good score from the judges, putting him into third place. Back up to the top of the hill, Zapotochny of Poland to go next. Just 19 years old, huge strength in depth, the Polish team. They really love their ski jumping. There's a huge number of followers across the country. Good landing. reasonable length as well. 84 meters. Held his body steady, legs straight, toes bent up at the ankles. Some of the features that the judges are looking for. So 109.8, and he moves into third place now. So Ryusei Ikeda of Japan is still out in front. Nikita Devyatkin of Kazakhstan sits second. But can Karhofer of Austria, the first Austrian we've seen on the hill tonight, good length as well. The Austrians amongst the favourites to do well here, and he's certainly started very well indeed with his first jump. Karhofer hits 91 metres, and his style was excellent. So 122.6, no surprise that he goes top of the leaderboard. Simon Joshko now, another Polish athlete, the last, the penultimate to go in this round. That was a good length. Shakes his head though. He felt he could have done better. 86 meters, not bad at all. That's the equal fifth best jump of the night. 16.5s coming through from the judges, and a total of 104.6 puts him in a good position, sixth place. Poland's Adam Niznik. Good flight and a good length, and he is happy with that, and so he should be, because it was 90 meters dead on. So 60 points in the bag. Now it's up to the judges. 118.2, and that puts him in second place behind the Austrian Karhofer. We've still got two more Austrians to come, including this man, Mika Schwan. And another long jump from the Austrians.
9-0.
Mika Schwan gets 90 meters. Lovely style, lands with his arms outstretched as the judges want. So 118.2 for him puts him into second place. A penultimate jumper, Max Lienherr of Austria, 23 years old. It's his birthday in a couple of weeks' time. Will he be celebrating with a medal? See how he does in his first jump. Yes, another great jump from the Austrians. 91 meters, and that matches his teammate Karhofer as the longest jump of the night so far. Under 19, so he goes second. 3 points, 3.5 points behind his teammate Karlhofer. So at the moment on that leaderboard, with just one jumper to go, it is Austria 1-2-3 right now. Daniil Vasilyev of Kazakhstan. Is the best jump of the night so far. What can Vasilyev do? Oh! He's gone much further. He has just jumped, I think, we wait for confirmation, but that could be the longest jump of the night so far.
92.5.
It is 93.5. And a great landing as well. A really good jump from Vasilyev. 127.2 gives him over a 5-point lead now at the top of the leaderboard, going into the final jump of the night. What a way to finish the first round. They will start the next round in reverse order, so Vasilyev will go last. Then we have Karlhofer, Linha and Schwan, the three Austrians. Niznik of Poland in fifth. Ikeda, the best placed Japanese man, in sixth. Simon Joshko of Poland. So Joshko managed 86 on his first jump. We're expecting more from him. Oh, that's a good flight. That's a long jump. He punches the air. He knows it's good. It felt good, didn't it? It was a really strong high launch off the table. 92.5 meters. The points are good from the judges as well. He now has 219.6, and that puts him in a gold medal position. Of age and showing his experience. He's been to the Olympic Games, to Pyeongchang, competed there at the highest level and put in a fantastic final jump. Look at the determination as he flies through the air and gets 91 meters to go top of the leaderboard. Zapotocny now of Poland. He hit 84 meters on his first run, but we're now seeing these jumps getting longer and longer. It's not going to be far enough for him. 85.5 meters. Good style, though. Judges like the technique. I'm seeing 17, 17 and a half's coming up. So he gets a total of 211.4, which puts him in third place. Seven more jumpers to go. And now the pressure is beginning to pile on. Nikita Devyatkin of Kazakhstan. Just short of the 90 meter mark. He's not happy with that. Managed 88 in the first run, and he's got 85.5 in this second jump. That is going to cost him dearly as far as the leaderboard is concerned.
I think he knew he made a little bit of a bobble on the end, Peter. A lot of ski jumping is really dictated on the takeoff, and then the flight position comes in just to carry it as far as it can go. But I like to say,
so here's our current leader from Kazakhstan, Sergei Kachenko. And he's just got the slimmest of leads of just over 1 point from Simon Joshko. Ryusei Ikeda now for Japan. Oh, another good jump. It's going to be at least 90 meters. 91, in fact. He's given 91 meters and some good scores from the judges coming through as well. In fact, those scores have put him top of the leaderboard. So a change of leader, 233.9 points just been made official for Ryusei Ikeda of Japan, the 22-year-old from Hokkaido. And now we're into the top five from the first round. They're separated by just 9 points, so this is wide open right now, with Niznik of Poland. He liked that jump, that felt good. Adam Niznik, 92.5 meters. That is a great jump. The scores, the style points may put him in the lead overall now. Yeah, great landing. 273.6 is now his total, and that gives him a 4 point lead at the top of the leaderboard. Adam Niznik currently sitting in that gold medal place. Polish teammates congratulating him as the Austrians start their attack. Mika Schwan sitting in fourth overall right now on 118.5. Another long jump. He managed 90 meters in the first round. And it's 92.5 this time round. It's going to come down to the style points. They're looking good. But it's not quite enough to go top. 237.4. Oh, that's 0.2 behind our leader Niznik. Into the final three jumpers. This is medal decision time. Max Lienher of Austria, the 23-year-old. An ultimate Austrian to head down the slope. 91 meters was his first round distance. Oh, it's got to be longer this time, surely. That is a really long jump. And good style, good technique as well. And that surely is going to see him move up the leaderboard. Another look at that. And you see how good that landing was. Almost on the 100 meter line. And his score, total score, 251.4, and he has now moved up into first place. So it's currently Lienha of Austria holding first, Niznik of Poland in second, Zwan of Austria in third. Two more jumpers left. It's Karhofer, the final Austrian to go. Managed 91 meters in the first round. Oh, another good solid jump. He's happy with it. 92.5 meters he's been given. And 92.5 gives him the lead. So it's currently Austria first, second, Poland in third. The final man to jump is Daniil Vasiliev. Oh, 248.8. So Karhofer in second. So Lienha, now we've done the maths, got the maths done properly. Lienha is out in front. Karhofer is second. And then Polas Niznik is third. Here we go with the final jumper. Vasiliev. He is jumping for gold. Can he put in a jump as good as his first round? Oh, yes, he does. That is an extraordinarily long jump. The man from Kazakhstan may well have done enough to take the gold. 97.5 meters. Just to put that into perspective, he's covered almost the same distance as Usain Bolt would, but at twice the speed. Fantastic jump. And the points have come through from the judges, and that confirms that Daniil Vasiliev of Kazakhstan has won the gold in the men's normal hill individual. His teammates carry him aloft with a flag as he's congratulated by the other competitors. Nice spirit there. Kazakhstan's Vasiliev wins the gold. Lienha of Austria takes silver, and his teammate Karhofer takes the bronze. But the most impressive on the hill today was Daniil Vasiliev, the 18-year-old from Kazakhstan. It's been terrific. Looking forward to the next event, which is the mixed relay, and that takes place right here at the Olympic jumping venue on Wednesday. Join us for that.